definitely going to be a four-wheel drive. Who will it be? Jamie Flannery in the Chevy Thunder. Chased closely by Chad Sleater, Dave Hawkins, Walker Evans, Jenny Flannery. The Shimon truck, 1334, 807, and 820 Sammer back in the back. She's now all over the place. We've got Jamie Flannery in the Class 4 for Ghost Run. Chad Sleater in the Heisman Court, putting in second. And Walker Evans coming on strong. Gaining on Chad Sleater going into the gravel pit. Dave Hawkins, Jenny Flannery, and 1334. Looks like Scotty Taylor already has a flat tire. Left hand rear is already flat on Scotty Taylor's number 800. We'll see if he can make it out of the pit. And Jenny Flannery having all kinds of trouble finding the handle on that number 815 Chevy Thunder. Second, Chad Sleater in a number 406 truck. Right behind him is Walker Evans. Has a two-wheel drive pickup truck going up against those four-wheel drive. He got himself around Chad Slater. Running in second place. Now he's got his sights set on Jamie Flannery. Hopefully Scott Smith will move it over and not hold up Jamie Flannery. Scott Smith had a little bit of trouble on the start. Hopefully he'll move over and let Jamie come on by. Jenny has spun number 815 in the gravel pit. Jenny has spun number 815, but he got it back around. He only lost one or two positions there. As Walker Evans has overtaken Chad Sleater and goes back into the woods in second position with Chad Sleater in the Heisman Ford taking up third position. Jamie Flannery has increased his lead on Walker Evans to 10 seconds. Jamie Flannery now has a 10-second lead on Walker Evans. That's McKee Scotty Taylor back out on the track. Scotty Taylor got that tire fixed, but he's way down in the field. We'll see how many places he can overtake. This is his last weekend. So you can expect Scotty Taylor to let it all hang out. And here comes our leader in the Chevy Thunder, 435, Jamie Flannery. Walker Evans still running in second at 817 yards. That two-wheel drive pickup. Third place, Chad Sleater driving at number 406. At last check, Jamie Flannery had a 12-second lead on Walker Evans. A 12-second lead out there for Jamie Flannery at last check. Fourth place, Jay Hackers, Mark Sillies running fifth at 13:34. Scotty Taylor back on the track after getting that left curve tire fixed. 807 has moved up. Got himself up. Dennis Bernard has moved up into sixth place. For Dennis Burdon. Chad Flannery is currently running sixth. Jamie Flannery, our leader, number 435, Jack Flannery's truck and four-wheel drive pick him up. Heavy Chevy Thunder. As he brings it around, Scotty Taylor comes around and right now number 800. There's our leader, 435, Jamie Flannery gets it sideways up here, coming off the first jump. Rover control, he's got a problem. Just died on him. Jamie Flannery's truck just died on him. 435 pulls off to the side. Look at Jamie, realize who that was. Hot nose number 802. They're doing a good job. Mark Summers, 1334.
24. Dennis Verdant should be coming around. Currently running in fifth any moment now. Here he comes. Dennis Verdant, number 807. Currently running in fifth.
R.J. Flanagan running in sixth and at 1369. Chet Flannery running seventh in 8:15.
Unofficially, Chuck Brand should come around in eighth place. There's Chuck. Oh, Chuck got overtaken by Lowell DeGreef. Lowell DeGreef overtook Chuck Brand on that last lap, moving himself up.
That eight of Flannery is down in the ninth. Watch him when he gets. These bolts are really weird.
What a bad break for Jamie Flannery with that 435 cutting out on him as he coming in his first jump on the front straightaway. And that's the market right down here in front of you, pulled by the mile. That puts the Marbury Coast Dodge up in front with Walker Evans, your leader.
And boy, is Scotty Taylor having fun out there. This is his last race of the weekend. He's a little bit down to the back. He's letting her all hang out on that board of his. He's just absolutely smoking.
Scotty Taylor has already worked his way back up to 11th position. And here comes your leader, Walker Evans. Second place, at number 406, Chad Slater. Third place, number 802, Dave Hocker. Fourth place, 1334, Joe Zillish. And number 807, Dennis Verdant. R.J. Flanagan, 1369, Jeff Flannery, 815.
We're going to have a race here between R.J. Flanagan and Jed Flannery. Jed's going to work real hard to overtake that sixth position from R.J. Flanagan.
Ninth is, eighth rather is, Shaboo, 1350. Looks like Chuck Brand has disappeared at Moose number 1399. John Jones up in the ninth place. And that means Scotty Taylor has entered the top 10. He should be running about 10th.
Scotty didn't come back around on that last lap, Ron. There was all of a sudden a bunch of smoke as Scotty went back in the woods and he hasn't come around again. It's too bad because he had to have been doing the fastest lap on the track there a couple of times around there. He was just flying. But Scotty pulled right to the pits. He hasn't come around again. Here comes our leader, Walker Evans. Coming around, the young Chad Schleter, number 406 in that orange and white Ford. Chuck's got her back out on the course, a couple more positions down.
Walker Evans with his wheel drive pickup truck getting out in front and staying out in front. Third position, Dave Hocker's number 802, just coming fastest.
Correction on that. We're calling that Chuck Brand. That's not Chuck Brand. That's his teammate, Don Gregor, number 1305. I call that, of course.
14th place, 1334. Joe Zillig just going up by the barn.
And here comes
place, number 807, Dennis Verdant. Sixth place, Chet Flannery being challenged by R.J. Flanagan. Chet Flannery overtaking R.J. Flanagan and moving up a spot.
Jenny Flannery currently running in sixth position out there. We can only take Don Dennis Verdant up there.
Morning. Evans. Oh, Jed Flannery right out in front of us, a little sideways coming off this hill. Flanagan can catch up a little bit, but I don't think he's got enough to get there. Second place, doing an excellent job of driving in that 406, Chad Slater.
You know, Ron, even though they're both Chevys, I bet you there's a world of difference between that short block Chevy of Dave Parsons that Jenny normally drives and that big block, number 815, that his dad built a few years ago.
Third place, Dave Hocker's number 802.
lap and see if Jetty is actually gaining on Dennis Verdon.
John Schultz running in 13.99 in ninth place. Here's your leader coming around again for Walker Evans, number 817.
Sure enough, Jetty's reeling him in. Muscle just put the stopwatch on the pit. Now there's only 2.5 second gap between Dennis Verdon and Jetty Slater. Can Jetty overtake Dennis Verdon, number 807? And has Dennis noticed in his rearview mirror that big Chevy Thunder purple hood coming up on him?
Second place, 406 in that hyphen truck, Chad Schneider. Orange and white truck going up by the barn.
Lowell DeGreeves back fender side of that bench, showing quite an angle as he goes out around Parsons Pond. Obviously, that truck's going to need a little bit of work again.
Walker Evans just about to lap the ninth place truck of John Schultz as they come across the finish line. There comes his third place vehicle, Dave Hockers.
Whoa, somebody lost the tire. Bouncing up down the track down there by the barn. Somebody's tire come off.
Can't tell. It's Farmer John, it looks like. Farmer John Connitzer, that blue truck up by the sweet hill up there.
And look at here, Jetty Flannery moves up one more position, working his way around the number 807 of Dennis Verdon. So Jetty Flannery moves his way all the way up from 7th through 6th, all the way up into 5th position.
That is it, Farmer John's tire. Whose tire was that that came off? Was the spare tire on the back of the truck? Must have been a spare coming off of somebody's back of the truck. A lot of these trucks carry a spare back there. The only thing I can think, when did the spare tires come off?
And Joe Zillich just broke an axle or something on the front of his Class 13 truck. Joe Zillich just pulled off the course. That moves Jetty Flannery all the way back up to third position, unofficially.
Second place truck just coming past, number 406. Third place being held down by Dave Hockers. Dave got an 802. Walker Evans brings us across the finish line one more time. We're running out of time here. Walker Evans, probably a lap and a half left. There's third place, Dave Hockers, number 802. Dennis Verdon up in the fourth place. Fifth place, R.J. Flanagan. What happened to Jim Flannery?
Tough news for that Chevy Thunder. We haven't seen him come around.
Shaboom coming by, number 1350. We lost Jim Flannery somewhere in the back over there. We can't tell if he's pulling his scissors out of the woods. And your leader, Walker Evans, number 817.
Flanagan is racing with Verdon down there. They're racing for position. Oh! Dennis Verdon and R.J. Flanagan got into each other. R.J. Flanagan got flipped over in that 30-something racing. Dennis Verdon has pulled over the side.
Okay,
Terry Friday, who does that put unofficially in third position?
Dave Hocker still running in third.
There goes Walker Evans, ladies and gentlemen. He's coming right for the checkered flag. The Maverick Bulls Racing Team, 8-17 with that big dodge. Walker Evans!
Behind him, one lap down, hold the green. And our second place car of Chad Bramish is going down to the gravel pit as we speak. Slater, I apologize. Chad Slater.
With a hell of a good run, I'll tell you that. Pardon my French.
Boy, there's only two Chads out here and I can't keep apart. That's pretty bad. Chad Slater coming around the finish line to take an unofficial second place in the Heavy Metal World Championship, True Value Championship weekend. There it is, Chad Slater with the big orange and white Ford.
Dave, what? This afternoon with these challenges of 2x4, 4x4 and Heavy Metal. You talk about an exciting weekend of racing.
Get that?
Wow.
Bill Nickel, you needed to
come back and show you the Dodge can run up front. So here we are. And just stand by because I think the truck will be back out on the line again.
He's going to.
Yeah. Hey, that sounds great. You heard that? Oh, look, Elijah. Okay, Walker's going to be back out.
Oh, is that going to be fun? Well, that's a big secret for right now. We'll just see that happen. Hey, we're in front. Okay, now second spot up here. We got Chad.
What if she flips it?
Boy, I thought Jack Heitman is really flying.
I don't think that truck can be there.
That's not Jack out there.
Yes.
Yeah, that's right. Hope we didn't jack her off today, though. I think it shows what a good product Ford puts out there. We can put a young fella like myself in there and run a really good second place in the race walk. I really got to thank Jack Heitman and all his crew. They did a good job prepping his car and getting it all set up. We're great. Thanks a lot, guys.
You looked like you'd been driving it for years, really. Now, that's got quite a bit longer wheelbase and a much different engine than you have. Did it take you a while to get wired in?
Yeah, it did. I think if we
Yeah, axles broke on the roof.